Billy, what are you doing?
I'm trying out Afterbirth Plus.
Which is a great goddamn name for an expansion.
It's the gross shit that comes out afterwards.
Wooly and I were just doing some wonderful wiki foo on when the fuck did what the fuck come out.
So apparently playing Rebirth, and the people were asking why we played that, because it was like, that was like playing Arcade Edition a week before Ultra Street Fighter came out.
Okay.
So you've become a huge, big, baby champ.
This game is great.
Between then and now.
No, wait. Back that up.
You've played a fuck ton of this.
I've played maybe 20 hours.
Okay, so...
It's a lot of fun.
So there's more to this, so...
There is a lot more.
So one might say that we can dive back in?
We can.
All right.
So my first big...
What was seed? What was that about? What was the seeding about?
The seed is if you type that into your new run, you can get the exact same room or layout as somebody else.
Oh, cool. Like a random seed number.
Yeah, it's like the Bloodborne Chalice Dungeons.
Okay. So
a couple things.
You gave me some advice.
Number one is use the analog stick for your controller.
Yeah.
Because there are attacks that you charge the attack.
So let's play this like a twin stick shooter.
And you wanna if you're charging, say something like Brimstone, which is the big laser beam, you wanna go into rooms with it ready to pop. But if you're using the buttons, it's hard to like maneuver your aiming around without letting it go off.
Okay.
The other thing that I'll say is that there is such a thing as what are they called? They're called blue rocks or tinted rocks. And basically, you see those rocks up there in the stage walls?
Yeah.
If they are lightly blue...
How do I pick shit up again?
You can't pick that up. That's a battery. That would recharge your ability to use your usable item.
And a bomb is...
LB.
LB, okay.
So, let's see what we got. Number one, tears up.
So all right. You've got the thing open? Okay, we got a slot machine. So
the slot machine, you basically pay money in order to randomly get bullshit.
Which I don't.
It is nearly never worth it.
Never worth it?
I have never seen it be worth it for me.
I'll save my.
I am now being told by humans that I am wrong. That it is super good.
Immediately, people.
So the basic deal with the rocks is that if you see a rock that is slightly blue or darker than other rocks, and it has an X somewhere on it, that will break, and you can get an item out of it.
Okay.
Also, that's a sacrifice room. If you were to walk into that and hurt yourself, you run the risk of possibly getting an item. And since there's a goddamn thing
nothing to lose, right?
There's not much to lose. Nope, didn't work. Fuck it.
All right.
Fuck me.
That's all that room is about?
Pretty much.
Huh.
So number one, it gives you a very high tier rate in exchange for a big range down. So your range is shit.
But high rate, high
tier. But you're shooting lots faster.
Big cries.
So if you were able to get a range up item, for example, that'd be very helpful.
Nice little machine.
Lots of battery drops.
More batteries
in here.
Coming.
Get fucked.
All right.
Also, you're gonna want to save your keys for the second floor. You see that gold door? That gold door will always have a character upgrade in it, right? Of some kind.
Okay.
However, the first floor is free. All other doors on all other floors will cost one key to get in.
So
that is a pill. That will have a completely random effect. The colors of the pills never maintain between games.
Okay.
You will never know what that pill is going to do.
Unless I bomb it right now.
Well, yeah, unless you bomb it and eat it.
So why don't I do that?
Yeah, why not?
Okay, bomb LB, you said?
Yep. There you go.
Can I destroy items?
No.
Good.
What do you got? Well, you can use it now, or you can use it...
RB, right?
Yeah, and you can use it... Full health. Well, that was nice. See, often, 90% of the time, you're going to waste pills because you're going to use it, and it's like, oh, it's a damaging thing, but I was in an empty room with no enemies.
Oh, are there, like, time-limited buffs, you mean?
They can do a wide variety of effects. They can...
got my bomb back.
You can piss your pants and shit your pants and cause a damage pool around you. You can increase your stats massively.
Okay.
You get all sorts of fucking weird shit. So fight this fucking boss. And when you're done with the boss, I'm going to help you with some interface changes that you may want to make. Also, second floor onwards, you're going to want to do everything in your power to not take any red damage.
Okay.
Right? So you get
hearts that are
silver
not red.
Hearts or black hearts or white hearts even. And those are fine. You can take that damage all you want. Oh boy.
This is already going rough.
Honestly, for a new player, the fucking number one seems terrible. Holy shit! That was lucky.
I bombed him.
All right, what's that?
Picture of mom.
Torn photo. Not much to say about that.
Shoot up speed is... I'm shooting even faster.
And your range is being increased.
Okay, if I, like... Is there some devil door that I need to walk through now?
No.
Okay, I can just drop.
Just make sure that you've explored the whole area. Before. You can hit select to see the whole map. You did not explore the store, and there are some items, but that's fine. You're good.
I have 15 coins.
Yeah. Hit start for a second. Go down into your options.
Oh, boy.
And what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to turn the extra HUD on.
Extra HUD.
Yeah, now you're going to turn the found HUD on. There you go.
Oh my god. Okay. 14 King, that's my seat, I suppose.
Woo. Okay, so in order, there's
Dex,
coins,
endurance.
Hold on. Coins, bombs, keys, movement speed, rate of fire. No, range. Range is the second one. Third is rate of fire. The lower, the better. The 116, I don't know what that is. The sword is damage.
Yeah.
The clover is luck. The upside down cross is devil, and the regular cross is angel.
Okay. And then my items over there. Or no.
That's your items over there. Then you have your score and your time.
But these are not my items. Those are my whatever.
Your pickups.
Pickups.
Your upgrades.
Passives. Okay.
Okay, I found the torn photo. It's exactly what it says.
So was not going into that. I'll go into that room next time, I guess. Whatever that was, that's fine.
Now don't take no damage, Wooly. Don't take no damage. Notice that when you entered the second floor, your devil percentage is now at 100%.
What the fuck is that?
When you beat the level, if you manage to take zero red damage,
then I get a
you will get a devil deal 100% of the time.
Okay, well, I can't
if you take one hit of damage, it will drop to 1%.
I can't promise I'm gonna do that.
You have to promise.
Like, what if I don't get it?
Then you will suck.
I'll suck?
Yeah. Welcome to streaming Binding of Isaac.
Really?
This is what it's like.
If you don't get perfect on the second floor.
No! Okay, so that's fine.
What?
That's
why
fine.
Why no?
That's fine.
Why? Right? Why no?
Why no? Well, because you actually had a lot of coins. I was wrong. So what you can do, here's two things. You can do three things.
Oh my god.
You can buy stuff from the guy.
Okay.
You can bomb the guy for items.
Okay.
You can pay the donation box money to upgrade the store in the future.
Okay.
Or you can bomb the donation box to get your money back for some reason.
Okay.
So let's look and find-
So if I bomb him, will he fight me or will he just die?
No, he will just die.
Okay, well, I'll just do that.
Yeah, why not?
But can I get free items out of it?
You can get free money out of it, usually.
Okay.
And I believe your devil or angel percentages will change. There, you got some coins. Right?
Okay.
So, let's go down, and I'm gonna try and find what that fucking power cable looks like.
Jeez.
Or you can just get it, if you want.
Hearts aren't bad.
Yeah, but that's not an extra heart pip. That just heals you.
Oh, okay.
Which makes it, like, a lot worse.
Alright, then let's find out what this is.
It's called the Sharp Plug. It charges with blood.
So that means the more I get hit, the more it'll charge.
I don't fucking know.
And donating to make the shop better. Sure, I'll do that.
Yeah, with your extras.
There.
Alright.
Does outing the flame do anything now?
Occasionally, outing the flame will get you, items from it.
Occasionally, so that means you have to do it every time.
Yes, you do. Treasure chests made out of stone. The only way to get what's in them is to bomb them.
Oh. Well, I'm not bomb, so.
Alright, I found the item that you got. When your spacebar item is out of charge, which is the upper left corner item that you don't currently have, you can press the spacebar, which is LT, or RT, I think, to use it at the cost of 2 health. The item only costs half a heart to use if you have the wafer or cancer items. The sharp plug will take health from soul or black hearts before taking red hearts.
Cancer
items. Also, careful, those are TNTs. If you blow those up, they will blow up real good.
Oh, with my tears, yeah?
Yes, you can blow them up like so. You have to hit them. There you go.
How big is it? Okay, that's how big the explosion is.
It's, 2 squares. Is the damage of explosions.
Yeah, feels like it might not be worth it to focus on that unless there's a huge group, because...
Yeah. Well, or it could accidentally blow a hole in a wall and give you access to a secret room.
Oh, that's a thing, eh?
Yeah.
Okay.
Unfortunately, your range down is really, really poor for blowing up TNT. So above that
that's
is
a pain door.
That's a sacrifice door. There's often good items in there.
But if I get hit right now, it's going to fuck up the thing.
But you need to, yeah, it'll fuck up the thing. It'll fuck up the devil door. And it'll hurt. Oh, that might be synth oil. No, it's adrenaline. Panic is power.
Panic power. Okay. Holy shit.
There used to be a mod that fucking did this.
This is crazy. This is Adam. This is... Oh my god.
All right, so
you
let's...
haven't stopped talking.
Let's find out what... Yeah, I know, right?
What the fuck?
Just explaining constantly.
I can't, like, there hasn't been one moment.
That we're just not talking... Oh, I'm trying to find adrenaline here. Oh my god, it's tough to find it. Oh boy, this is a tough one. Oh, I can't find it, Wooly. Help. You kill those items.
I didn't get hit.
Good job. What? Adrenaline?
All right. Arcade. There's an arcade now.
Okay. If you want to use one coin to go in the arcade, you can. However, you're out of coins.
Yes, I am.
Also, make sure to destroy all poops and stages.
All poops. Oh, there's a coin.
Yes. You got it. That's actually 5 points.
So
you
can
go
into
the arcade if you desire.
Is it good stuff?
You pay coins to gamble for items.
Okay. He wants money.
Okay. So, the shell game guy, if you blow him up, you will turn some of your percentage chance of getting a devil door into an angel door.
Is that an angel door good?
Angel doors? So devil doors are massive buffs in exchange for permanent health.
Yeah.
Angel doors are not as good, but it's just purely beneficial.
I see.
So there's benefits to both.
Okay. Well, I'll go with the devil door then, I guess. Oh no, I can blow him up for a chance at an angel? It's not guaranteed?
You can blow him up and it'll just you gave him a coin. Alright, so okay. Now you paid him a coin, find your key. Nope. And you took damage, and now your devil door chances are 11%.
Because that hurt you for guessing wrong.
That's correct.
Well, then I might as well blow him up.
Might as well. You did it. So you got some devil door goodness. You got 35% chance. You're back up to 46% chance.
That's the chance of running into the door.
Yeah. After the boss.
I see. Now I'm back. Look, I'm back to 81.
Good. That's great.
What the fuck? Why did that happen?
I don't fucking know!
Alright, well, the only place to go on the map is that room that hurt me and then the room up there. Okay. So let's go there.
Why can't I find the adrenaline item on this fucking list?
I don't know, man. So this guy's just a beggar and then there's a boss door here.
You can blow that beggar up too.
For free money?
Yeah.
But don't touch
occasionally. It may make you look like an asshole. No, the beggar? Yeah, the beggar. Just murder him. Just kill him. There. Oh, nice! You got the wiggle worm!
Wiggle worm?
Look what that does!
My shots wiggle.
Your shots wiggle a little bit.
Wiggle.
Their effective range does not decrease, but it does make them more wide horizontally. Monstro is pretty easy. He's not so tough.
But
he did, for some reason, spawn in with 2 ads, which you should take care of immediately, because they are going to spawn spiders.
Oh, these guys, yeah?
Yeah. Well, okay, well, there's your devil door chance. However, oh, I see what adrenaline does. As you take damage, your stats go up. See, your damage is going up as you're taking damage. Substantially.
I see.
However, you are dead.
Oh, God, the ads are fucking... Oh, Jesus! Okay.
Alright, that's a good first run. Now hit it again. Now hit it again.
Now do it again.
You fucking idiot loser. Just do it.
Stop being so shit.
Alright, so those things are gonna hurt you. They're not gonna hurt you. They're just gonna slow you down. That's great! You got a fucking health regen or a soul heart. What a fucking great start.
So what are the stone hearts exactly? It's not a blood heart. Like, the damage doesn't count towards anything?
So the gray hearts are called soul hearts. And what the deal with them is, they are not recoverable. You cannot heal them.
Yeah.
But they also do not count as real damage for any purpose.
For statistics, like anything that needs damage,
yeah.
It doesn't count.
There are also devil doors.
That's a boss door
right
away.
That's a boss door, so you just ignore that fucking shit.
Yeah.
Fuck out of there!
Alright.
There are also devil deals that deal explicitly in soul hearts.
God.
Yeah, no, you'll get there.
Why are these guys...
It takes some doing, man. It takes some doing. So here's the thing. And here's where it gets really fucked up. And people told me about this, and I was like, that's stupid and bullshit. I don't think that's that bad. And that's where that clip of me on stream came from, where it goes, everybody told me Afterbirth was really hard, but I don't think it's... And I just die. So
may your rage bring me power.
Okay, hold on. You hold on to that for a second.
I got the Empress.
You might want to bomb that to get that soul heart.
Okay. Oh, money.
Money, good for you.
Okay.
All right, I'm getting the Empress card. I'm getting it out. So you gotta scroll really far to get to the fucking cards.
You have to just recognize on.
All right, gives the player the Horror of Babylon effect for the current room.
Okay.
So only for the current room.
Horror of Babylon is white.
Horror of Babylon means that when your health dips to one heart if you're Eve, or half of one heart when you're Isaac, you gain a massive damage up.
Okay. Oh no.
Oh, you fuck! Careful! Oh, wait!
It's a stone heart. It's a stone heart.
Yeah.
Okay.
Silver heart, whatever the fuck it's called. Don't go down there!
That's a level drop?
That's a level skip.
Oh, that's... Oh, no. Okay, so this is an item, right?
Not get that gross baby.
Okay. Immortal friend.
Day baby. Is that day baby?
Is he an option? Is he gonna follow me?
There are a lot of them that are options.
Okay. The fuck is he? Okay, we got Keydor and Freedor.
What the fuck was that thing called, Wooly?
I don't know!
God.
You were
damn it.
You said baby, but I didn't read it.
All you have to do is read the thing.
Can you tell based on the picture?
I can, but that takes longer.
All right. Is it sacrifice door? I mean sacrifice room?
Yeah, sacrifice room. I personally never go for them. The health damage is nearly never worse.
It's not guaranteed.
Okay, well, I saw it said baby, so I'm just going to go control F for baby.
What the fuck is this thing?
That? Oh, that is to swap. You pay one coin, and it swaps the items in the room.
Oh, okay. Now this is another card, and this is-
That is a random card and a random pill. You will not know what they do.
Well, is that a swap?
I found the baby. Okay. Alright, it's a dry baby. I'm sorry. It's a familiar that follows Isaac and blocks shots that hit it.
Okay, so I have to position myself behind him.
If a projectile is dropped, blocked by the dry baby,
okay.
He has a high chance to activate the Necronomicon.
I'm excited!
What's that do? What did you just do?
I ate a pill and now I'm excited.
You're very excited?
Yeah.
Okay, well, shit. Give me- Huh.
Okay.
Okay, well, you're out of stuff now. And you're definitely not gonna wanna use- Oh, you used the key on the first floor? Did you?
Yeah.
Okay, don't use a key on a first floor, ever.
Ever.
Yeah, because all second floor onward, the buff rooms require keys. So that means you may not be able to get into the buff room until the end of the next stage, or ever. Okay.
Alright.
Okay. He has a high chance of activating the Necronomicon effect, dealing 40 damage to the whole room if the dry baby blocks something.
Alright, so now to the boss then.
Yeah. The chance to activate is not changed by your luck stat, and it can be gotten by destroying skulls. Alright, now while you do that, I'm gonna try and find the pill effect for I'm Excited. Enjoy this shit, by the way! Oh, you've activated the Horror of Babylon! You now do much more damage.
I'm strong. I'm really strong.
And you didn't have to go underneath a pill effect to get it.
Yeah.
All right, this is good. Killed the boss, killing the poops.
The poops actually matter, huh?
Yeah, the poops matter. Any adds spawned by the boss have to be killed to move onwards.
Wow, okay.
All right, get that shit. Roid Rage says what it does.
Yeah.
Now, if you desire, you can go back and drop into that other room.
What, the other drop?
Yeah, the other drop.
And that'll
And we'll see what the fuck that does.
Oh, that might go somewhere, huh?
It might.
Okay. Yeah, and there goes my Babylon.
Yeah, it only lasts for the one room, unfortunately.
Yeah. Okay. Fine, where does this take me?
Trying to find, I'm excited, trying to find it. It just skips the stage. So you could have skipped the,
No, toilet paper.
Unfortunately, I cannot find the I'm Excited pill thing.
All right, double.
I'm having trouble with Platinum God right here.
Vortex of some kind. Oh, good shield. Ah, damn it. This teleporting, fuck.
Did you take damage? But it wasn't real damage.
It wasn't real damage.
That's what I like to call real damage. Now remember, you also want to be on the look- Oh, yeah, Necronomicon effect!
That's random?
Yeah, it's- the dry baby took a shot.
Okay.
It did big damage. So you don't- so, treasure chests also have, if they have a keyhole on it, that means it takes a key.
Okay.
I would not use it on anything other than a gold one, because it's not really worth it. So yeah, here- that's the buff room you can't go into now.
I see.
And that's a bummer.
There's no running from rooms, huh?
There is items that keep doors open. Okay. I was just reading about one earlier. So I'm gonna be scanning your rooms for rocks. Oh yeah, backing up slowly and letting the dry baby take
totally
hits is super good.
That's totally
careful with that. Now you can nudge that TNT, I think.
Can I just walk it over?
Thank you. No, unfortunately you cannot. All right. Well,
that's that.
No, that's that. You don't have any bombs. You can't even do anything.
Okay. Oh my god.
There's so much, dude. There's infinite depth in this weird baby shit game.
It's kind of absurd.
It's very absurd.
Okay.
Also, you may notice that nearly every upgrade change. Oh, those are spawners.
Oh, you can kill the spawners.
Yeah, you can. So the other thing is that you may notice that every single item you pick up makes Isaac look different.
Yeah, they do. They do. And I saw those pictures where I was like, I don't know what the fuck.
By the end of any successful run, you will be a deformed mega baby.
Okay. Down there is a cross.
Okay, so that symbol, the one that you see, that little symbol,
yeah.
That's a shop. Okay. So if you don't have cash, don't use the key to get in there.
That's a fucking waste.
Yeah. Uh-oh. Here we go. Block shots. Oh, no!
Now I'm down to real damage.
Yeah, so you ran in front, and baby always falls behind you.
I was trying to get him forward a little bit, but then he shot.
Well, remember, use your analog stick to aim.
I am. No bomb. Oh, I have one bomb.
You have one bomb, and it will go down. Bombs go two squares. So if you put it right at the top there, it will be reachable. Yes. There you go.
Great.
And you got a bomb out of it.
Okay.
Fucking great. Are any of these secret blocks? No. Great.
They look slightly blue?
Nope. Yeah, they look slightly blue, and they have an X on them.
Okay. Then there was a door over this way.
And hopefully you'll find a key in there.
Because
leaving this... Oh, man. If they don't drop a key, you're losing out on that buff for light, period. Hopefully maybe the boss will drop a key. Oh! Oh! So dangerous. Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Lucky. Well, you're not getting that buff.
So beat the boss perfect, huh?
Beat the boss perfect. Okay. No mistakes.
For a chance.
Well, now it's 100%. 100%
now
chance
it's
of getting a double. And it's Monstro.
Please.
Lucky you.
No ads, please.
You got lucky. This is the best version of Monstro. Don't use bombs unless they're special bombs on bosses. It's a massive waste of resources.
I just wanted the perfection of it.
I know. But it's a massive waste of resources when you don't have bombs. There are items that will let you multiply your bombs, and that's rad. Yeah, good job, baby. Oh, you might get it. Looks like you're getting it. Dodge. Looks like you're going to do it. So Monstro is who I end up fighting most of the time. He's very easy, as you can see. Like, his pattern is dead simple. You did it.
Okay.
You got a double door for sure. You got Monstro's tooth. That item's now unlocked. Pick up that shit. Mom's coin purse. What the fuck is this? You now have a shitload of
random
pills.
Things. Okay. Do the colors matter?
They're all random.
I can just pop them now.
I'm excited. Hit it. Don't know what that does. Range up!
Wow.
Considerably. Are you a wizard?
I shoot diagonally.
Yeah, that one's terrible.
No, that's really bad. I don't like that at all.
Paralysis!
I can't move.
Temporarily.
Okay, now I can move. Alright, so the devil door is this one.
Yes.
So, now we go in. The hearts were moving away from me.
What the fuck is this? I've never seen this!
Do I make a deal?
They're beggars for hearts!
I don't want that. I want to make a devil deal. Right? So I go up here.
No, the devil deal is items are in front of him and he trades you for hearts. I don't even know what the fuck would happen. So they will take your heart if you talk to them, but they may give you a random item? I don't fucking know. I've never seen this.
Well, there's two hearts in the last room.
Yeah.
So I can find out.
You can try, but it might be...
Try it
again. Okay, get the fuck out of here. This is a fucking piece of shit.
Oh no, they won't. All right.
Well, unfortunately, you're not gonna get the buff that was in that second.
But I got some buffs here.
A little bit, yeah.
Off those pills.
So. You got Mom's coins purse, which I'm gonna be looking up in one second.
I can carry more money. I don't know. What is that?
I don't know. Maybe it just drops those pills. Right? Maybe mom's coin purse takes the pills.
Oh, mom had pills. Okay, flooded caves. This is new to me. Let's go up.
Yeah, there's a bunch of these. Looking for the coin purse, looking for the coin purse. There's a lot of mom items in this game. There it is. Mom's coin purse. Drops four random pills on the floor. So all you really got out of that was the, what do you call it? Was the rage up. There you go. You're dead.
Holy shit, this room.
You really want those buffs.
Oh, you aren't kidding.
Oh, dude, it gets super real, super... Get that phone! No!
What? Why? What? What?
There was a buff room right next to you. And you got really unlucky because you ended up fighting Sloth.
What the fuck just happened?
Okay, yeah, you can do it, you can do it. Just continue on, Wooly. So here's the thing.
That, just to pretend that didn't happen.
There's a couple,
I don't even know what just happened!
There's three ways in which you get better at this game. You get better at the, just the physicality of moving Isaac around and shooting,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
You get better at general knowledge of the mechanics, and you also get better at, like, specific knowledge of items. And whether or not you should pick up an item
right,
up or use it or not.
Okay.
So here's a good one. I don't know. What does that do? It telepills. It teleported you somewhere.
Okay. So I'm kind of get it because I've been playing a lot more Necrodancer, and I totally understand the...
Oh, those will not hurt you. They just push you.
Oh, thank God.
The poops hurt you.
Oh, they're just... Okay, they just... that's how they...
Yeah, they push you into other enemies.
Okay, I was worried because I knew they disappeared when I came.
All right, so here's a good example, Wooly. There is a hidden rock. There is a blue rock in this room right now. Can you see it?
Yeah, this one.
Yeah. So blow that up with a bomb, and you'll get something. Okay.
I blew up that fire and got this.
How did you start this? Okay, well, you don't have a key. So if you get a key, come back, because gold chests are totally worth it.
And that's enough. But don't go in there.
Don't go in there, because that's a shop, and you're broke.
Yeah.
And break all those poops. Poops. There are items, like there's a Pope hat, that when you break poops, you have a 40% chance or some bullshit of finding a soul heart. It's really crazy.
Pope hates poop.
He loves poop. He finds his soul in poop. Oh, yeah, is that the flatworm? Careful. The orange fire shoot at you.
Oh, that was an enemy, okay.
Yeah. Yeah, flatworm's great. Okay. Check out your shots.
Oh, yeah.
They are much wider.
Wide.
And no other downside at all.
So,
yeah, buff room. Good job. Careful.
Fake buff room. Oh, no, it is a buff room.
They're always real buff rooms. Key. Fucking great. What do you got?
Mom's reusable pill generator.
All right, so what? That's pretty simple. So every one of those pips is a cleared room.
Yeah.
So you use it with LT, and you'll get a pill.
Okay.
And the pill can be random.
Okay. I'm going to go open that chest.
Yeah, go for it.
Dog?
You got Cricket's head!
Cricket's head?
Cricket's head is a massive damage up!
Yeah? Okay. So no, you don't save that, you just use it, right?
Yeah. So things on the right are permanent.
Okay.
Things in the upper left are usable. Things in the bottom left are modifiers that can be traded out. Oh my god, Cricket's head's a really good one.
Okay. Alright.
That's a really, really good start. Hold on, let me find Cricket's. Where the fuck is Cricket's head? There it is. I want to get the exact description of it. Okay, so it's damage up. It's a damage multiplier. Tears now have a knockback effect.
Wow.
Can be found in golden chests. Cricket's head used to be known as Max's head in the original game, and it was renamed for Rebirth.
All right,
so you want to go. So yeah, that was a fucking great buff.
Okay. Good. So
your damage, like, doubled off of that.
That's fine.
So here's the thing. If you're going to be using the secret items, you want to use them the usable items, you want to use them immediately, because every cleared room recharges one pip.
Oh, okay.
So if you're going to use it constantly.
What hit me?
I believe an exploding fly hit you.
Shit.
Okay, you got a pill. What's the pill do?
Lemon party.
Okay, so lemon party does damage if people stand and piss.
People in the piss, yeah.
Yeah.
No bombs.
No bombs.
And there would be I'd get a bomb back.
Yeah. No, that's not get a bomb back. That means that thing will just explode.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, fine. Let me get those hearts then.
Yeah, absolutely. Backtrack, get some hearts.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. trying to play this while keeping in mind what's going on.
It's like, tough.
No, you just have
when
to.
When I've been streaming it's this, be it's this for... constant thing where you I beat a room and then I stop for multiple minutes. That being said, that damage increase is huge. You got really lucky getting the flatworm and Cricket's head.
Cricket's head. Hey, we got a bomb. Okay, yeah. So maybe I could use it here.
That's not worth it. So chests go from gray, red, gray, brown, red, gold, right?
Okay.
Increasing value. I rarely use items to get anything but the gold chests because the gold chests are so good. So careful when you kill Larry because Larry can split into two depending on how what part of him you blow up. And there you go. However, you're doing crazy damage. You got the screw.
Okay. No devil door?
No devil door.
Because of...
You're getting massive, simple buffs.
No devil door because of damage?
No devil door because it's level one. Oh. Level one never has a devil door.
You're right.
So check out your new shots.
Yeah. Okay.
That's huge, big damage.
Big buff. Okay. All right. Nothing else here then, I don't think.
Yeah, you did it. Your character is... That's a really good first room. First floor.
Jesus Christ. The dress! Ah, you wore the dress. Yeah, okay. Right.
So yeah, this is a kind of, like, when fucking Eyepatch Wolf was talking about it. So that door will not open for a while. I think you have to kill most of the enemies on the stage to get it open. But I still have yet to determine the... So remember, any keys you find, it's for that thing.
That's what you want the keys
for. And if you see a key that you can bomb your way to, prioritize it. Like, there are items that are weird that give you infinite keys for certain floors or double your keys or all sorts of weird fucking shit.
Okay.
But for now, you're just at zero. Yeah. You motherfucker. So those things don't have any projectiles unless you pop their head off. But you're doing so much damage.
And the bodies will split off. I remember the body has a...
You're doing so much damage, however, that that's not a realistic worry.
All right.
Down to the bottom left, there is a blue rock. Bottom left of the stage. That's a blue rock.
Yeah, okay. All right.
And it will get you a bomb back.
You're talking about this?
Yeah, that one. Because it has an X on it as well. You see how it's slightly tinted?
I see the X.
Yeah. It's tough. Yo. Okay, well, you're not going to be able to get that right away. But remember, you want two keys.
Two keys.
You're going to want to prioritize the room first and then the chest. But
these I have trouble with these guys.
Well...
I have a lot.
That's fine. You'll get used to them. But they are quite annoying. I don't like them. This would actually be way harder if you did not have the super wide shots that you have. Alright, key!
Okay.
Quickly! So, to,
The shop.
To the fucking buff room. Or whatever the fuck it's called. Gold door room. You have two in here! You have two in here!
I get both. It's not a choice.
You have 360 tiers! So you have now gained actual 360 shots.
Actual twin shooter.
Now,
okay.
Nice hat. What's that called? Post hat? Okay.
Oh, man. Okay, pots don't break. Yeah, okay.
So that's one of the weird things is you'll get items that change the game's core mechanics in ways that you did not think would occur.
It's a bit insane. Yeah, okay. All right.
No, not host baby. Not host eye. Not little horn. Host hat. Where are you at, host hat?
Oh, gold fly.
Okay. Bomb. I got a bomb. None of these are X'd. All right. North. Oh, these jumpers. Fuck these jumpers. At least they're not burning. Well, I already took a hit, so it doesn't even matter anymore.
Yeah, well, you can still gain it back. I'm trying to find this hat. I'm having a little bit of trouble, honestly.
Okay.
There's a lot of hats in the game. You just keep doing well.
Yeah. Each fly color means a thing, right?
Every fly color means a thing. Okay.
What do you mean, thumbs up. I got a thumbs up. Creepy bombs.
Bombs bladder. Creepy bombs. So I can tell you right now. I'm pretty sure I know what bomb that does. It will make your bombs poisonous.
But it replaces my flatworm shot, which I like more.
Yes. So I'm of the opinion that shot buffs are way more important
because you're
than
fucking
bomb
using them
buffs.
24/7. Yeah. And then,
oh, that's why I can't find some things. I'm on the goddamn... I'm not on anti-birth plus. I'm only on anti-birth.
Afterbirth.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I can't do anything without keys, so I'm just going into the boss room now.
I'm on the... I was an idiot. Anti-birth, by the way, is a fucking mod that I was looking at.
Okay. So I'm just going to go into the boss room, unless going to that damage door up there was a thing.
Don't go to the damage door. Right, well. And if you want a pill, pop it now.
Oh, yeah.
I got a pill. I wasted a bomb. Infested.
Oh, that's really good. That'll spawn spiders on you. And spiders do 2.5 times your shot damage.
And they attack the boss?
All right, now fuck up monster so hard. Look how hard you're fucking him up. You can't believe this shit. These ads aren't fucking shit. You took damage. That sucks.
But my percentage was already low.
Yeah, but it was 36%. Oh. Now it's down to 1. You always want to take as little damage as possible. Well, for obvious reasons.
For obvious reasons.
But also for less obvious reasons.
Oh, I could have just sniped.
Oh, you got mom's photo again.
Oh, okay. Tier shot speed up.
Dude, your base damage is gigantic.
Okay, no devil doors, but oh well. Alright.
Oh, man.
Oh, boy.
No wonder I was having trouble. I was on the wrong fucking wiki.
Well, and then the items change completely from game to game.
Anti-birth isn't even official. It's a fucking mod.
Oh, okay. We're back to 100% devil. Is that for every floor, by the way?
Yes, usually, it seems.
Alright, so I'm...
So that's Rat. Be careful. He's Bomberman.
I'm just fighting a boss right away.
So by defeating Wrath, Envy, Lust, etc., you can get... Oh, yeah! Look at that lucky shit! You can get items that you normally wouldn't otherwise be able to get.
Wow, keys. And a bomb over there.
And a pill that you can choose to use or not.
I hope it doesn't do anything bad.
One.
That's good. Hitbox is much smaller now.
Okay. Using pills always is pretty much like, just do it and see what happens, right?
Depends how ballsy you want to be, man.
How much you like your build, yeah.
Fuck this. I gotta fucking... Okay, now I can... Cool, careful. So anything that has like a red dot or is holding a red dot will explode into shit like that.
Holding a red dot.
So the fly was holding a bullet. And when you killed it, it got that bullet. So you may be wondering why the fuck you can't get that, and that's because flight and ladders are options.
But not right now, because I can't. Diagonal shooting changes so much.
Yeah, dude. Basically, every single time I played this game, I've gotten some kind of upgrade that makes me go, oh, this is the way to play it, and then I'm never, ever going to get that item ever again. It's really frustrating. There, okay. Found the host hat, finally. It has a random chance to deflect some tiers. Oh man, you got your damage down. No, it doesn't look like many devil doors on this run. Also, those things will explode in your mouth.
Got it.
You have a buff door at the bottom.
And 2 keys.
Yeah, so hold on. Okay, never mind. Fuck it. That is... Now, hold on just 1 second so I can finish telling you about your hat.
Yeah, okay.
It has a random chance to deflect some tiers.
Okay.
And it will cause you to become immune to explosions, stomp damage... also counts as an explosion.
That's why the bomb didn't hurt me that I dropped.
Yep.
Okay.
And what do we got here? That's a tier. Anti-gravity. Anti-gravity tiers. And tiers up.
Oh my god.
Stop moving.
Oh, wow.
Okay, well this requires no explanation.
Holy shit. Do they hurt in place, is all I need to know.
They very... Well, let's see. It's very weird, Wooly. Just leave them and see what happens. No, I mean, like, just go all over the stage and see them if them try and walk into one.
This is hard to... Yeah, okay. This is not the best right now, but I'm not
But it has potential!
Yeah, you just have to learn how to use it.
Against bosses, this is annihilatory.
Because they're gonna just keep moving into it, yes.
But yeah, you did it.
Okay,
now be careful. You don't currently have any,
health.
You have any health? You can pop a pill, and see maybe a pill will heal you.
Okay, LT?
LT, that'd be what we want, yeah. Maybe it'll help. Health up? Well, your max health is up.
But
not your current health.
Alright.
So you gotta be real careful.
Alright, let's see what's on the map. There's a shop down there, nothing really.
Yeah, you don't really seem to have
enough. Do it.
Careful, that the blue one will explode, and the,
My
into bombs.
Oh man. Okay.
All right, restart. Do it.
Okay, now that's a door. That's good shit.
Yeah, that's good shit. Always good shit. Get it. Oh no. Oh, you didn't get it either.
Fuck. You have to keep walking into it.
Yeah. Double whiz shot.
That kind of sucks.
Just kill yourself. Just fuck that run.
Jesus. Why so mean?
Oh, man. All right, Wooly, here's your last run. Get ready. There's nothing to kill in this room. Just try and get out alive. You be careful. Soul Heart right off the beginning. Great. All right, Generator. Careful of those spiders. They're very fast. Very bad.
I can't shoot diagonal anymore. I gotta remember that.
Isn't it fucking weird to have mechanics just taken away from
they're
you?
They're gone. I completely forgot. Okay.
Oh, careful of those.
They're gonna pop.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. No, they don't pop. They have that circle shit. There you go. You did it. No.
Accidental. Accidental.
All right. So a lot of this game is you move in a direction and you start screaming at yourself. You're just like, no, why?
You gotta learn fly colors.
You gotta learn all the colors. You gotta learn every enemy. Every enemy. They're all scary. They're all bad. They're all evil. So any glowing blood you see like that, glowing piss, glowing shit, anything like that, that's damaging the floor. So don't step on it.
Okay.
So it went away, but enemies that leave trails like that. Oh, fucking Jesus Christ! Oh my God!
That's worth it.
Bomb that shit!
Okay. That's not gonna destroy any of it, right?
No! Oh my God, fucking get all that! Steven, great!
Damage up.
Check out your fucking brain. Libra, you feel balanced. So what that does is it balances your stats overall and makes you better on average.
Okay.
And now you have a buff door over there, too. Oh, that's Monstrous Tooth. Dog Tooth. Bark at the moon. General buff. Damn also, it. If you hear a dog bark, that means there's a secret room in the area you're in.
Okay.
So you got generalized good buffs.
Generalized, yeah, I'm Ryu right now.
Yeah, at some point you also got 6 bombs. I'm not sure where that came from. Might be from one of the upgrades. Also, you have soul hearts going into stage 2, which means you're going to be able to more easily get the double door in the second floor. Wait, stop. Go back in there. Okay, so either the top or the bottom is a secret room.
Like
dead center at
dead
the top.
Center?
Yeah, like that.
Like you'd have to bomb it.
Yeah, and it might be the top or the bottom. You won't know until you do it. You got lucky. It's the top. Okay, get away from the poop and safely kill the poop from a distance. So that means it'll aggro on you when its poop is dead.
He will aggro?
Yeah. You didn't get anything from this. Kill the fire. Nothing from the fire? Nothing from that? Alright, last things last is you can bomb that guy.
Yeah, I guess so. And his fly?
Yeah, his fly may aggro once he's dead. Well, you got nothing. That room was worthless.
Completely pointless.
It was completely without all value.
It wasted...
2 bombs. And time.
And it is a question mark. Alright, well, let's go.
Alright, let's fight the boss. Come on, Monstro. Larry Jr.'s not so bad. You're really... you should be really happy. There's a boss called Ragman. Which is an annihilator. It's a fucking run annihilator. He's so awful. He's very commonly the first boss that I fight, and I can't beat him with the fucking default gear.
Oh yeah, it's just
like he's so fucking tough. Now over time you're gonna get really, really used to Larry Jr., Monstro, Peepers, guys like that, that just generally you fight on floors 1 through 3 or whatever. He also dropped poop. What is that?
What is that?
Cat of Nine Tails, shot speed and damage up.
Okay.
That was, you traded, oh my God, look at that fucking thing. I'm gonna do Cat of Nine Tails just to check.
Shot speed seems kind of, yeah, it's a bit faster. It's a bit faster. It's not like crazy fast, but it's all right.
Where's Cat of Nine Tails in this list? I gotta find it.
It's where you flail yourself for your sins.
Yeah, man.
Okay.
A lot of Jesus stuff in this game. A lot of Jesus. There's the Cat of Nine Tails.
Jesus.
All right. Damage up, shot speed up, an item found only in the boss room pool. So, nothing special or fancy or weird about it. And again, you've gotten quite lucky. You have just a set of generalized strong buffs.
Oh boy.
Now, occasionally, when that happens... So, any enemy that is colored weird is either stronger or has some weird property like that. Usually the darker colored ones, blue and dark blue and black, explode into like Ikaruga style like shit at you.
Bullet.
So yeah, destroy all the poop, destroy all the fires. Like, look, you have a full pip of heart just in this room waiting for you.
I can take a free hit.
No, don't.
No.
Get that devil door.
I know.
That devil door. All right, so he is leaving a piss trail behind him. A horrible fuck. Oh, no. Oh, God. He also does more damage in general. He will also regenerate himself from death.
And he walks fast.
Yeah. So he's back, for example. You have to kill him and his clump. Nice. He dropped
hard.
A shitload of health, but it's worthless to you now.
Hearts I don't need.
Yeah, careful of those black on fire headless babies.
And that's an attack fire.
Boy, that's a fucking phrase.
That's an attack fire.
Yeah, it sure is.
Okay.
All right. Now, you're not done. There's somebody left alive in this room. Otherwise, the door would have opened.
Another attack fire?
No.
Oh, no, that's just a locked door. Okay, I'm wrong. All right. That.
So
kill that other fire. And then, this game, you can play this forever.
I can see that.
Yeah, like,
I can see the
every permutation and synergistic set of events.
Oh, wolf.
Wolf, hidden door. Now, so it's lucky when you get to hidden doors that have three open doors on them. Because then you get to, okay, you can open that for free. And, oh, you get a free bomb. So even if you fuck up. So it's either the top or the left, and it'd be dead center. Go left? All right, let's see what you got. Unlucky.
What the fuck?
Luckily, you've been doing pretty well with bombs here. There you go.
Hope this one's not as useless.
Okay, don't touch those poops. Try and get those hearts. See what happens.
I can't. I have no damage.
Okay, well, kill those poops. Now, those poops will regenerate.
Enchanted poop.
Okay, so red poop will hurt you.
Oh.
All right, that's all that's in this room. Cool room in many runs, not so much for yours.
No, not when you're doing good. Okay. Or doing okay, I suppose.
Yeah, the main thing you would want is something that would give you soul hearts.
Yeah. Fuck. All
right. Or black hearts.
Okay, so let me go back this way.
Yeah. Also, if you touch fire with your body, you will take damage.
Of course you will.
I learned that the bad way. So these ones are annoying as shit because they will chase you like fucking crazy. And that was a really fucking clutch run. And you're right in front of your buff door. You will gain your buff momentarily. Careful that corn one that will create a fly that will attack you, but it may have an item. Nope, didn't. And there's another,
another fly.
There's another corn poop.
Okay, so that's what the corn is about.
The corn means the fly will attack you if you kill the poop.
Okay, got it.
Think about it. Obviously.
Yes.
Obviously.
But there might still be good things in
it.
So it's still worth it.
There's so much in this game. And yeah, no, you're right. I have not stopped talking and explaining
mechanics the whole time. It's insane. That
buff door, that's great. That's perfect.
I
you have seven keys. It's for free. What the fuck is that? You got the
friendly
ball. Gotta fetch them all.
That went right up to where my pill is. It's a reusable.
Yeah, let's see what friendly ball does. Probably says something cool. Let's scroll. Friendly ball. Holy shit, this is complicated. Hold up. When used, can be thrown at an enemy to capture them like a Pokeball. After capturing an enemy, the next use of the friendly ball will respawn the same enemy as a friendly companion, which will attack other enemies. The companion will persist between rooms and floors until it dies by taking enough damage.
That's amazing.
So if you see, like, a fucking boss enemy...
Well, no, you can't kill a boss.
No, I mean, like, one of the big, larger-than-others red or black enemy or whatever, pick it.
Or, like, one of these guys.
There's a hidden room in here, and that will be hard for you to find. There's also a hidden block right next to you.
Yes, yeah, okay. These guys, I need to just do what I can.
Be really lame. Be as lame as you want.
Yeah.
Basically, you're waiting until you get
a lucky shot
where you're pretty much already aimed up.
And I'm hiding around the rocks here. I'm just going to absolutely do it like this.
Yeah. Their shots are really slow, but areas like the one that where it was vertical, like, they're fast enough that they can tag you. Basically, they're actually tougher to deal with in rooms like this, in which you can block it, because what you want is for it to be totally open with clear sight lines so you can just start aiming immediately. Now it's going to be tough because he's going to be spawning far away from you, and your shots are not fast. In fact, your shots are slower than his. You're just going to have to chase him and get him, like so. Oh, one more, and you're done. Oh, 2-1. Oh, come on. Come on, you fuck. Yeah, see? See how annoying that motherfucker is? Yeah, you did it. All right, pop that fucking bomb right there.
Yes.
You might get soul hearts out of it, and that'd be dope as shit, wouldn't it? You got soul heart out of it, and a key.
And a key.
Isn't that just the best?
Wow, 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 wow. Locked. Two keys.
Two keys.
Three keys. Okay.
All right, now that you have a combat door and a fucking sacrifice door, don't even bother with that shit. Get the fuck out of here.
Was there anything in this on this floor that I missed with a key?
No.
So I just
you can hit select and you'll be able to see. No.
Yeah, what about the shop?
The shop? You have 16. You can hit the shop if you desire. And you also have tons of keys.
Yeah.
Oh, and there's a hidden room in here to the right. It's only to the right, because it's the only place it could fucking be.
Yeah, okay, so...
And you're good on bombs still? Alright, get careful, careful. Alright, hit, kill his shit, kill the fires before popping that, just in case.
Yeah, this...
Also, if you're fighting huge amounts of flies, the fire will kill them if they fly into them.
Okay.
Oh, okay,
These rooms have been shit, so
These rooms have been really shit for you.
I don't like
them. I have nothing to tell you other than...
I'm gonna ignore
than
them.
Sorry.
I might ignore them from now on. Yeah. That's a waste of a bomb. Shop.
All right. Yeah, you got a shop here? Yeah, all right. And you have 16 coins, which could be worth something. I don't know what that mass of garbage is. If you give me a minute, I can check.
Mass of garbage.
Hey, Wooly, talk about something interesting for a bit.
The more absurd this game becomes, the less I'm bothered by it on a personal level, because I cannot relate to going through poop dungeons infinitely.
Well, not until you die.
Or defeating my mother. I can't relate to any of those things.
Well, yeah, because that's not going
to
happen.
Also, she wasn't just religious, but she was, like, kicking him off and all those little backstory things where bad things happened to him. It was like, that's just absurdly terrible. All right,
this is a weird one. Compost. Gain more friends. When used, it's a usable item. It will replace your Pokeball.
Oh.
Doubles up the current number of blue flies and spiders that you have. Compost will also destroy every consumable on the ground in the current room and turn each of them into a blue fly or blue spider. If you have no pickups on the ground on the current room and no other flies or spiders, compost will spawn one blue fly or blue spider. That is a synergy item if you're rocking the Lord of Flies or any of that stuff.
Okay. I'm going to keep my Pokeball.
Yeah. Your Pokeball's good. Boss room's up and like...
I should have used it on something, though.
Yeah. Because remember, it regens. Every pip is a cleared four. Little Horn sucks. Good luck with this.
Yeah.
Kill those. They will stay forever. The bombs you can't kill, but you can move them away from yourself with shots.
Can I Pokeball them?
No.
Oh, those are going to make me fall, aren't they?
They sure will, and they will also give you damage.
Oh!
So you have to be doing all of this and take shots at Little Horn.
Okay.
And he has phases. He is my second most hated after Ragman.
Oh, boy.
He's horrible.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I see what you're doing now.
He's fucking terrible. I hate him.
Oh, he's a challenge. You gotta stay on your toes. Oh, boy.
If you can get a spot like that where they just happen to be perfectly lined up and you're not moving there...
And he teleports.
He teleports. He will teleport bombs at you. He will teleport bombs in his current spot. He will teleport the teleport at you.
What's his name?
Little Horn. He's a bastard. He's also got a big brother called Big Horn,
which is
the same boss but shittier.
Yeah.
And larger. And now he's in his final phase where he's just gonna keep doing that. You got a double door, motherfucker.
Yes. Okay. So
that is a straight up HP up. This is the best item to get before a double door.
Okay. So...
Alright, so that's the Horror Babylon and Guppy on the left. Guppy is the shit.
Alright. Little Horn talked shit in the Bible. That's his deal. The Little Horn was barking mad shit. It's gonna cost me a heart to eat to get the Cat Head.
Cat Head is good. It is a reusable fly hive.
Sure?
Yes. So hit it.
Hit it?
Hit it. Hit LB.
But
sorry.
Hit
trigger, right? You now have three flies. Every room that you clear, you get three flies.
And the flies are?
They will attack people with like five times the level of your shot.
They fly out and attack
people. They will fly out and attack people. They also take hits for you.
Okay.
It is an amazing item.
Okay.
and it is part of the Lord of the Flies transformation set.
Lord of the Flies is a
there
thing.
There are transformations in which if you can get all of a certain type of item, you will transform into a boss character that will just wreck the whole game.
And it cost me a permanent heart for that.
Yes, which is great, and that's why it was so awesome that you got the heart right before the Devil Rune.
See, so that's what I'm talking about, is like, his mother gave him shit for his birthday. Like, an actual box of feces. And like, that's ridiculous, because the idea that she's like, oh.
So I'm not sure if you're aware, but you saw that your flies like go out and immediately kill some enemies.
Yeah.
It makes it a lot easier.
I didn't even
pop your flies before leaving the room. Every single time.
Okay. And you get it, and it costs one room.
Yeah, it costs one room. So do it every single room. Oh, you got lucky. You got your buff door right. See how it just solved that for you? It's really good.
That's fantastic. I can't fly, but
And it seems to be random.
A random number, yeah.
Yeah. Rosary.
Yeah, faith up.
You see what just happened to your hearts? You got three hearts off that.
Okay, yeah. So the Devil Door was a permanent heart cost, by the way. It wasn't like damage, it was like
is permanent. Because the items you get out of Devil Deals are fucking fantastic.
Okay.
Wow! You're in there. You are starting to have a good run in which, guess what? You are becoming very strong.
That's a really strong run. That's really
careful that piss blood.
Yeah. He's squirting it.
Ah! That's fine. That was only... Yeah, there you go.
One glass heart.
Yeah, so you want to back up and kill those nerve endings far away.
But the flies only start for the beginning of the room. Okay.
Yeah, Faith, I think the rosary also has a...
I have so many keys.
Yeah, so that's good. That's good.
Glass heart for 5, and then 15 on that.
I don't know what the fuck that is. What?
Look up that cross.
I'm gonna look.
Because if it's shitty, I'm just gonna buy the heart.
Okay, hold on, give me a second. There's a lot of items on this fucking page. It's a sick-looking cross on top of a symbol, right?
Yeah, sick-looking cross. Yeah.
All right.
Looks like some church shit. Might be a snowflake.
Yeah, also the Jesus and general Christian imagery really helps with, like, a lot of the theming, because it's super cool. Is that the same cross? Found it. Chaos! Chaos causes all item pedestals to now be chosen from a random item pool instead of the predefined ones that they usually do. So that means item, like, bosses will drop gold chest items, and... a gold chest can drop boss items, and everything in between.
We're doing it.
Okay?
We did it.
If an item is... Oh, there's more.
I got a pill.
Yeah. If an item is chosen from an exhausted pool, it will spawn a breakfast pickup item instead, and when picked up, it will also drop between 1 and 6 random pickups on the floor.
Okay.
So it dropped only the pill. Okay.
Now, I like my body. Yeah. I like myself right now. I don't want to fuck that up.
Okay.
So that pill might fuck that up.
Or it could give you a buff. That's up to you. It's your choice. Also, if you bomb him, if you put the bomb in between those two things, you can bomb both of them, you'll get enough to buy another heart.
Oh, between him and the right here?
Because it goes 2 pips.
Okay.
All right. Only 1. Shit. That sucks. Well, when you get a coin, come back.
Okay.
You get the pip.
Okay.
Make your decision!
No. I feel like I can fight strong right now.
All right.
Okay, so...
Yeah, so though that starts happening more and more where you need flight or you need ladder or something to get over those items.
Ooh.
Careful about those ones.
Yeah, they're coming.
So if you're aiming straight at them, they will not hit you. Because they go diagonal.
I can shoot over the pits, right?
Yeah. So there's a type of upgrade called Ethereal Tears, which you would really like, and it's where your shots ignore the environment.
Oh, that's awesome. Okay.
That's a tarot card as well.
See, I'm looking at, like, those pits as things you can fall into.
You cannot.
Yeah, and...
See? That's what gets you with those.
Those angles, okay.
Yeah, so what's this? The sun. Okay, the sun will,
May enlighten and heal you.
Yeah, so that's a really good one.
May.
But, I'm gonna just double check what its buffs are. It's mainly a heal. A card with 3 uses. A full heal deals 100 damage to everything in the current room, and it reveals the entire map for the current floor.
Okay.
It's a good one.
Okay.
But Here's your choice. Do you want to use it on a big room that's tough? Do you want to heal yourself? Or do you want to smack the boss with a huge damage?
I'd rather smack the boss.
Yeah, that's what I usually thought.
Yeah,
that's what seems to be up your alley. Guppy!
I mean, seeing the map is sounds nice, but, you know. I heard the door. I heard the thing, too.
Yeah.
I heard the wolf.
Ugh. Gotta be careful, man. You gotta, basically, when you come... Oh, it's fucking sick! Just do it!
Yeah, okay. So
there's no downside at all! Key and health.
Fine.
You lost, you gained nothing. These guys are assholes. They will regenerate themselves from death. You need to, like, completely destroy their body. Bombs are very rarely effective because of the way that you run away from people in this game.
No, I get that, I get that.
You can get the bomb upgrades. See, because you're not... Yep. You gotta kill their whole bodies. There you go. Yeah, that's a fuck, isn't it?
It's a fuck. I just lost so much of my...
You lost, like, what, 4 or 5 health there?
On this one
Pop
room.
Your hive. Backtrack, get health.
Get health. Oh, God, this room fucked me up good. Fuck me up, fam.
Who is fam in this scenario? You can't get that.
Mom.
Alright. Well, continue onwards, young Isaac.
Jeez.
Also, you the characters you unlock, they either start with predetermined items. Hello?
No downside here?
No downside. They either start with predetermined items, weird stats, or increased shit like luck. Like, Kane is exactly the same as Isaac. Starts with one less pip, but he has a luck modifier, which makes him more lucky in general.
Oh, okay, okay.
Oh, fuck that thing up! Careful, they explode! Oh no, I'm thinking of the other fatter bats.
Fat bat. You motherfucker. You son of a bitch.
Yeah, that's the one I was telling you about earlier, like the fly covering the thing. But because it was on top of the generator, I couldn't even see it. Alright, are you ready for the boss? Hit that boss!
With no fucking life.
Whatever, you can do it. You have the sun.
Yeah, maybe.
The power of the sun.
But it's random.
It is random.
It's also the worst stand.
It's a good stand.
The sun stand.
All right, let's see what you got.
LT or LB?
For what?
For the sun.
The sun would be right trigger or RB. Doesn't really matter. You got Big Horn.
It hurt him.
It hurt him a little. So if you get really lucky, you can hit the bombs back into him. But it's tough. Sure is. Yeah, Bighorn's a fuck. I find him easier than Littlehorn though, because his shit that pops up is more telegraph. Oh my god!
Why? I don't know why I got those, but okay. Oh fuck. Oh, into the fire.
Yeah, that was lucky.
That was pretty lucky.
Yeah, I have no idea why you got those. That's super weird. But fuck it, that's good to have. So those are the same as little horns.
But they're so much faster and stronger.
And bigger.
Okay.
Yeah, you doing it. See, every floor defeated, no matter how direly, is a chance for some busted synergy to occur. Right?
I want to bomb him so good.
Ugh. You can bomb him on the large one. Like that.
Yeah, okay.
Because he always comes out of it. Those things also follow weird rules in which they don't track or home. They're on geometric rules.
Just going wherever they feel like it.
No, when you hit them, they always go in a predetermined geometric path.
Okay.
So they're like pool balls instead of tracking.
Okay.
Except for that one. Okay. So there's two types. The ones with mist on them track. The ones without mist on them act like pool
balls.
I
didn't even notice the mist, dude.
See that one's misty.
Yeah.
That one tracks.
Yeah. Okay. Now I noticed it.
Oh. You can see? Nap more. Yeah, this is a good run. This is a good run.
All right,
there's potential here. There's potential here. I just... Oh. See, and he does that. He goes to the fucking safe spot like an asshole. All right. Oh!
Bible.
Get the Bible.
The Bible. Temporary flight.
Okay. So, the Bible will let you fly. It also has more effects.
I traded off my cat head, though.
No, you want that Bible.
Really?
Especially in early games, and that's the weird part.
Oh, wait, you told me something about Mom with the Bible.
Bible's an instant win.
Yeah, that's cool, if I get to her.
Yeah, if you get to Mom, Bible just kills Mom immediately.
So I guess we're done on this floor.
Looks like.
This temporary flight might be good.
Okay, that's not the Bible. That was the Necronomicon that I was looking at. Okay, Bible. Gives Isaac angel wings for the current room. If used during Mom's foot or Mom's heart boss fights, the Bible will kill Mom instantly. If used during the Satan fight, the Bible will instantly kill Isaac.
Oh. Okay. Alright.
Alright, you're good to go.
It takes 6 rooms to get it up there, though.
Yep.
So
don't use it on...
Does it make moving around just easy in general and better? Is there like a...
Flight is amazing. Flight is your movement ignores the environment entirely. That's a 2-key door for the shop.
I have 2 keys.
If you want to buy something.
16. Maybe it'll be good.
Well, I'd clear the rest of the floor.
All right. Yeah, see where we get.
What the fuck is that? Is that worth getting?
Might be.
Okay, you're gonna have to continue.
No, wait. The second set of spikes aren't receding.
Okay. So, you know what would be really helpful here? Mm-hmm. Flight.
Yeah. Okay.
You had a rosary bead. You have faith up.
Okay.
What the fuck does that do?
I hope faith is good.
I'm looking it up right now.
This room sucks.
Yes, you hear a lot of that. There's a room that people were throwing around that people fucking emailed to the director of the game, and he's like, "That room is coming right the fuck out. It's a run ender. It's impossible to defeat.
Impossible room.
It's a room that somehow made it into the base game that cannot be defeated."
And none of the rooms are planned, right? They're pretty random.
I believe they are planned.
Oh, the rooms themselves
like,
are planned.
Like, or the algorithms that create what's in the room is planned. But there is a bug in which the algorithm can create this room in which there's a generator in between, like, 8 enemies, and you can't actually fucking kill it. It's the worst.
God, okay, glass hearts. Man, I hate how... What did I pick up? What was that thing down there? It was a faith up, right?
Yeah.
I have to spend that, or it's just on me?
No, it's just on you. Okay, rosary bead. Increases your chance to find an angel room instead of a devil room. That's what the rosaries do. That one will explode into a bomb. You also broke the door, so you can leave this room if you want early. But it's not cleared, and you'll have to go back in there if you want what's in there. But you can safely ignore it.
Oh, kidding me with this.
Oh, no. No kidding.
Are you fucking me with this?
Get good. Get good, shit scrub.
Man, okay,
the blood's fine, it's not glowing.
At least my shots go far.
But I believe it makes you slide?
I don't feel it, maybe a little bit? I don't feel it.
Get that shit!
Oh, thank god. You fuck. You fuck.
So the green is poison trail and poison explosion. These are mini monstros you're looking at. I don't know. It's tough, man. I don't know what the orange one did. The orange one dropped a coin, I think, and you got it. It gets there, bro. Unfortunately, you have not gotten the brimstone, which would have solved every problem. Brimstone is the best attack upgrade. It's fucking amazing. Do you want to use it? Do you not? Something's wrong. Oh, you just shit your pants with black blood.
Black shits.
Enjoy.
Oh, well, there's a lot of
room. Enjoy, motherfucker. I've gotten this exact room.
No, this is all right.
I have gotten this exact room before.
I'm very okay with the birth, the wideness of my... Okay.
Are you?
But you know what I mean.
Are you, motherfucker?
I like...
So careful, those ones spin.
They spin. Okay.
Ride and spin us.
Oh, no.
Ride and spin us. We don't stop.
Mm-hmm. How many spins?
I don't know, I had it on for like, in the background.
A day or two.
Dude, you gotta be careful.
I know.
You gotta be careful. Cause you're close, you are one floor away from Mom.
I don't know if I can do it.
It's a good feeling though to fight Mom though. It's very cool. Don't you want the video to be cool, Wooly? What an asshole thing to do and say!
Goddamn piece of shit you are. Alright, that's a locked door. And then this is another door. Alright. No hearts on the map anywhere.
No hearts on the map anywhere.
one away from flight two.
You wouldn't want to use flight anyway, because the next four is mom. So, and you wouldn't want a chance going in there without it.
Oh, you have to spend it. That's true.
Yeah. I imagine that's going to make them all retract. Nice. Seriously. Joker! Alright, you continue exploring. There is one or two rooms you left behind. And I will ask the wiki what Joker does. Joker is... teleports you to the Devil Deal room on the current floor. So,
yeah.
Finish the rooms up so you can heal up. Damn.
I don't know.
Damn.
I don't know about this. I don't know about this. I don't know about this.
Yeah. Yeah. You need health so badly.
Dude.
Yeah. Come on, health. Well, you got a key. Is there a shop on this floor? Yes, there was. Remember, you ignored it? Because it takes two keys.
Yes, it did.
Go. Go to shop now.
Go to shop, man.
I am a fuck. Also, there
hidden
is
room.
A hidden room on one of these walls.
Alright, well, shop first.
Shop first.
Battery.
Don't touch that chest! It will kill you!
That's a kill chest.
Yeah.
This is a card.
Pick the card first. See what you get.
I gotta bomb that.
Yeah. See what you got.
Open your eyes and see. I don't know, but teleporting to the devil door. Oh no, now I can't do anything in the devil door.
What the fuck is the world?
The world's the baby thing? Got it. Reveals the entire map. That's it. Alright, well.
I can spend it and still pick my card back up, can't I?
Yeah. You'll at least see... Oh, you never got the buff room on this floor, man. You never got the buff room on the floor.
Shit.
Okay. You gotta get that buff room. It might have health. It might have something that gives you health. This is gonna be a tough one right here. This is gonna be a tough one right here. I tell you what. I tell you what.
No one spits at me.
They may spit. That was super worth it. Get that heart, get that heart, get that heart, get that heart, motherfucker! Wooly, that was fucking clutch as shit. That was clutch as shit.
Okay. Buffer.
Yeah. Yeah. Joker. Okay, so these guys, basically, they track you.
Yeah, I mean,
they don't have- oh my god. They don't have any weird properties. They don't explode weird, they just run after you in a straight line like assholes. That one, however, is bullshit. Stay as far away from that thing as you fucking can when you kill it. Also, if you step on the spider webs, it will slow you down. It won't hurt you, but it will slow you down. I know that feeling. I know that fucking feeling. And you gotta kill these motherfuckers. See, you got unlucky because you have regular tears.
Yeah, I never got better tears.
You never got, like, weird additions to your tier base. Tier base? Yeah, like that, like that, like that. Yeah, okay. No. And then, yeah, like that. That's a perfect one. Great. Okay. Get that bomb. There's a shop underneath you.
That's a shop. Yeah, and then there's a bomb.
We misread the other one. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Get the health. Get the health. Get the health.
That's, yes.
Get the health. Okay, well, it's something.
$3 for keys.
That razor.
And then that razor. Yeah,
the razor hurts you.
For sure it hurts you.
The razor, I believe what it is it hurts you and it allows you to, and the reason why you would want it to hurt you is so that you can trigger, effects that only proc on damage.
Oh, I see.
There's a dull razor which lets you do it and it doesn't hurt you, which okay. is way better.
That's way gooder.
Alright, so now you only have your buffer room.
So, killing him is just money, right?
It's yeah, pretty much.
Never hurts?
Very unlikely.
I've only one bomb left, I don't want to trance it.
All right, let's see.
Not with an instant kill on mom.
What is that? That's a friendly fly.
Okay.
I don't recognize what it is. Big, beautiful fly.
You're a buddy? He's just gonna bud. He's just gonna chum it up.
I'm gonna look this up, because that's a weird one.
He's chumming it up.
That's a very...
Okay, well, I guess that's all we got, then.
A large, familiar black fly that bounces around the room, exploding on contact with enemies, doing 70 damage. It does not explode if it hits Isaac. However, if it explodes on an enemy while Isaac is in range, it will hurt Isaac. Respawns after 10 seconds. Picking up this item, as well as two other fly-type items, will allow you to turn into the Lord of Flies.
Okay, I see. So that's an adventure room over here.
Yeah, that you decided against.
I should.
You're running weird risks now, right? It's like, do you want to go in there for the chance of health? You will not be able to leave if you go in there, unless you blow up the door.
I'm just going to go to the boss.
Yeah, just go to the boss.
I've been doing okay with bosses so far.
Oh, there is the secret room to your left.
It
you can use
to left.
To your left.
But, okay, yes, that's a mistake.
And if you blow that up, there may be health in there. Who knows?
Please be a good room once, you stupid dog.
Put money in it. Nothing happens.
Basically. You can try, though. You can try. But enemies might come out. Oh, a coin came out, so that's okay. You can try it again. Careful. Enemies can... Okay. Oof. So health, you see, can come out as well.
Okay, but there's an exit door. I can just run out if an enemy
yeah, you
comes
can,
out.
Well, yes. And it's not a door. It's also a...
I really want health.
Any amount of health, honestly.
The money's so worth it right now.
It just keeps giving you money.
Yeah, this is goofy. Please.
Oh, yeah! You know what? You know what the black heart does?
What?
If you fucking lose it, everybody in the room takes 40 damage.
Oh, wow!
So often in earlier rooms, if you lose the black heart, the whole room will just beat itself.
Fuck
now, you need to be very careful of your fly buddy. He will respawn every 10 seconds.
But he can't.
Okay, so here's where the weird part comes in. You may want to actually go to the devil door.
To get mom.
To get a devil door that would take a pip or two, but make you strong enough to keep going.
Okay, alright. So we can go to the devil door right now.
You can go to the devil door right now and see what you get.
No.
Let's check.
Those fires are going to hurt me.
Those fires are going to hurt you, so don't go up there. Or try and out them. Okay, now let's see. I'm gonna look for the dog biscuit. The Bomberman one is not good. That will have something to do with your bombs.
Yeah, which I have zero of right now.
Dog treat, dog treat. Anything that looks like a dog treat. Come on, man. Come on, video game. I just want a fucking dog treat item. There are so many items.
Yeah.
There are so... Here it is, dog biscuit. Got
yeah.
it.
Whoa.
It's a snack, plus one health up. So...
Sacrifice a heart to
get a heart? I don't know what that'll do. That's really weird.
I won't touch it. Fuck it.
HP up. Yeah, that's what it says.
So I'm going to walk out here into the boss room.
That's how that's going to work, yeah. You will instantly be in the boss room. Nope, you're not. Oh, wow, you're just in where the fuck you started. Weird. Okay, to the boss room.
All right. That's so confusing.
Oh, boy.
I'm so confused by so much.
Okay, so never use the Bible again unless you're fighting mom.
And you don't go straight to mom. She's
no, she's the boss of her floor.
Yeah.
So there's more chance for a comeback.
All right. This run needs to be good. Okay. Wait. Oh no, I hit the button.
You hit the button, so it's fine. Can't remember.
Stain? I don't remember him at all.
What is that?
I don't know. I don't remember him. Don't touch those poops. You touch those poops? Okay, so that's what he does. His gimmick is that he is gonna throw down AoEs and actual bullet hell patterns. Like, for real.
It hurt him a lot.
Yeah, it hurt him a lot. As much damage as you can get out there.
Please.
This is actually... You got pretty lucky. This boss is not that bad.
Yeah!
Real Chubby appeared in the basement and he dropped a shit ton of health. Get that fucking shit!
Oh.
Don't touch those reds.
No. But there might be good things.
There might be good things. I don't think reds actually contain good things because they regen.
Oh, Bomb Buddy, you're so good. I'm cursed. What does that mean? Well, we're going on anyway.
Curse of the Tower is the worst item in the entire world.
Why is that? Why?
I'm going to triple check, but I'm pretty sure I know what it does. You're not going to be happy. You're going to be very unhappy. in fact.
Why?
Let's find you, Curse of the Tower.
I'm gonna play.
So there's a card version that you can use, and then there's the item pickup version that you can get.
Well, I was having pretty good luck so far, but
the tower is something that when I picked it up, everyone went crazy, and I couldn't believe how far I got.
There's a sword room.
That go in there, it won't attack you. Get the fuck out of there. Only that means when you open the chest, combat will happen.
Yeah, okay.
But if you see two or three gold chests, totally worth it.
Okay,
so don't go into a new room before I explain this, because you're gonna get super pissed and you might need a minute. Curse of the Tower, you feel cursed. Causes Isaac to spawn 6 troll bombs on the floor every time he gets hit.
That's what happened. Okay, I saw what happened. But they can hurt the other people.
Yes, but
just
they
be
will,
aware of it.
They will spawn on top of you.
Okay, so I just gotta be aware of it.
Yeah.
Okay, that's fine.
So every time you get hit.
Yes.
Okay.
Got it.
Ready?
I have half a glass heart.
All right. Oh, no, it's any hit. It doesn't matter if it's health or not. That guy is really helpful. Careful, careful. It'll hurt you.
I know. It deals with the situation, though. I'll tell you what.
And those will, again, regenerate the monster.
Yeah. Fuck.
I know, right?
Get away!
Oh, you stupid bastards. So you have to run from your own buff.
Yeah. Which is pretty cool.
And when you're in cleanup, too, careful. Oh, a big coin. That's nice.
Okay. That's a hallway, and there's something up in the next room.
Yeah. So your primary goal here is find that buff room as fast as you can.
Yes.
Oh my god. So use the key and pop that thing.
There you go.
Because otherwise you would have had to make the quick trip around. Oh, bombs.
How many? 3.
You got 3.
Okay.
You would have had to make the long trip around, which could have resulted in damage. You're doing it. Those are beams! Oh god!
What?
That actually worked out really well. Isn't that lucky?
I don't even know what happened.
You got hit in the troll bomb
spawn. Yeah, they did.
Okay. You're just gonna have to fucking do it.
Yeah.
He slides when he fucking moves!
Yeah, he does. Fucking hand.
So those ones are really infuriating. Those things have a really high chance of, if you can get them, they spawn soul hearts way more often than average.
But I can't get to
them. But you can't get them.
I have the Bible, though.
Don't use the Bible unless you're fighting Mom.
Bible. Yeah, I won't use the Bible. I will, however... Oh, no.
Be very careful. That's what you should do. So those troll bombs are actually helping you out a little bit.
More than a little bit.
So those things, the chomping face, you can only attack them never. So you can't hurt them.
Okay.
Hit the shop.
Yeah.
And then save one key. See if there's health in here. There's the dog treat!
Okay, hold on. 15 and 3. That's exactly perfect. Okay. HP up.
And then the dog treat. Sorry, the heart.
Yeah, of course.
Nailed it.
Perfect.
Dude, how lucky is that?
That is really lucky.
Yes!
Oh, we're doing it. And luck into unluck.
And if you walk into the boss room with Mom, you win.
Yeah. Curse is pretty all right. Tell you what.
You got really lucky.
Except
not
that.
That lucky.
But there's the boss room.
If you want, you can just walk in and instantly win.
I want to do it.
Just make sure Mom's on the screen when you hit the Bible.
Okay.
What?
What?
Did we miscount the rooms?
Why'd you lie to me?
I think we miscounted the rooms.
Why'd you lie to me?
Well, I mean, I'm not perfect.
Well, now...
Now you... Oh.
I mean,
I'm not a perfect man.
Where's the troll bomb?
If you get hit.
Like now?
Yep.
Oh, he's tough. Oh, but they're doing the work. But I'm dead. Okay.
I want to apologize. I misread the number of bosses.
That was a run, though. That was an honest run.
So you can you're starting to see how certain items can combine with others to just be like, no, that's bullshit.
Holy shit.
That's bullshit.
Fuck this after.